Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys the HDR panel. So much like the color wheels here in the primaries or the log, we have some controls under HDR that are similar, like temp, tint, hue, contrast, these things. But underneath these panels, we have global on the right here, and then these first three change as you work your way down here. And much like the color slice, if you click on the highlight, it'll show you, based on the image, what region you're about to change on any of the wheels here. So if we click on the dark and it highlights, you can also shift H, whichever your last selection was, much like color slice. And then here's the absolute dark region for the black, your shadow. And then if we go up a little higher, here's the light. So let's just make a few little adjustments. Let's go to shadow and we'll warm this up a little bit. With Command D, we can before, after, and our skin tones are getting a little bit warmer, but the background got cool off, completely different feel to it, like less horror, I guess. And this is all on a single node here. We can play with some of the other parameters here. How it works is you have an exposure and a saturation, so that's also kind of like the color slice tool. Then you have an X and Y parameter, but these actually lock into the crosshairs of whatever wheel you're on. And then you have this fall off, which is this little red line to the right of the wheel. It's also controlled right here. So depending on, you can think of that as your blend. So if you bring it all the way down, it's kind of non-existent. If you crank it all the way up, it gets more aggressive. So just depending on where you need it to be, but there's quite a bit of flexibility just in that. And then all the other regular controls. You can think of these bottom ones like globals. And then for the global, you can lean to whatever color you need, adjust the exposure, same thing. And then if you wanted to see where you're at on the ranges, we have a couple of boxes here. There's like a spectrograph, and it'll let you know what range you're in and just give you this little readout to let you know where you're at on any of the parameters. If you wanted to have a secondary look and see where you're at, and you can actually slide. So instead of it telling you where it's perceiving the ranges to fall off, you could actually adjust it a little bit if there was some more of the image you needed to adjust. So like this highlight here is just getting the flame. If we go back over to here and click on our highlight, we can actually move that around with these sliders. So if we came down a little further and we went back and highlighted, you can see we're getting a little more of their shirts and some of the other reflections, like the little peak from the chalices in the background here. As far as specular goes, we don't really have anything in the speculars because we don't have an HDR fed image in here. That's like super bright. You have to have calibrated equipment to use that, but you can still use the global and anything below specular, at least in my experience so far. So if you wanted to work on just the dark parts or the shadows, like let's look at that. So you could see where that dresser, the furniture is, the lamp. If we were to just bring up the exposure on this, you can see what that's doing. Bring it up a little bit higher here. And so that's changing quite a bit of the roll off in the shadows. Let's go to the dark here, and that'll get more of the jacket. So let's say you wanted your shadows to be tinted and you don't want them to be pure black. You're going for like maybe the teal and orange look. You could actually adjust your shadows over or your blacks. And as you can see with the dresser there, it makes quite a bit of a difference. His jacket now isn't quite sitting. We got red lower than the green and blue. So those are elevated. You could see a little bit of the tint going on there. Especially if we zoom all the way out here, give you a full screen, this thing would cooperate. So the black's a little bit off now. So if you wanted that kind of look, and then you can still adjust these other parameters. You could do this in parallel along with your other adjustments, but don't overlook the HDR section of the color wheels just because it says high dynamic range on it. All right, I hope that helps. Thanks for watching as always, and I'll see you guys on the next one.